Kathmandu's Durbar Square, or what's left of it. As you can see, the earthquake has been extremely damaging, and we constantly imagined what it would have looked like just a few years ago.
Ah, that's the chariot we saw yesterday, with all the greenery on top of it.
Back to the buildings. We are extremely fascinated by the intricacy of details that adorn these temples. Wait a second, what is that? This? Are those three people? Something is going on here. Well, anyway, irregardless of the extensive damage, we were of course amazed. Visiting the royal palace left us enchanted, and we explored the courtyards filled with awe and... Santiago is being silly again.
So, good morning to you all. We have just discovered what Giacomo wants to be his new house. Look at... This kind of Giacomo looking at his new house with his astonished eyes.
Super beautiful buildings, and if you want, you can taste some goat lungs.
Maybe another time. For now, I take one golden temple, please. So then we entered a door and climbed some steps and ended up here. It was quite extraordinary to sneak into the daily rituals of these people, and we sat there for quite a bit.
Babia.
The Durbar Square of Patan was even better than the one of Kathmandu, and we even had a nice chat with some local guys who come here to play ping pong every evening. This is some unflattering footage of Santiago's skills.
So we found these guys playing ping pong and, well, we joined them, and they're very nice, part of the very curious shirt that this guy is having. I don't know if you've noticed. Yeah, exactly. That's not a wish me luck sign.
It was a Nepali New Year, so alongside the celebrations, there was a healthy amount of sacrifices taking place around town.
And that's the future.
Anyways, this beautifully historic town was the set for the movie Little Buddha by Bertolucci. Still today, people play in this square, though another kind of play.
Such a pity how much got destroyed.
Yet a lot still remains, and we were quite happy to thoroughly see it all. The beautiful parts, and the parts with goat intestines and blood all over the temple floor. They were even roasting one of the goats nearby.
Italy, no American.
No, Italy.
And then we got back to the main historical part, and this happened. crowd was growing and the celebration for the new year was beginning.
Happy New Year!
You see, it's all about the chariot. It gets pulled and pushed by two teams of men along the track of the street. Only sometimes there are a few problems with buildings in the way, for example. Or electrical cables. Mind you, the streets were packed, even downhill, and the chariot has no brakes, so I was very scared that someone might get hurt, especially here. You see the people in the front running for their lives. This is my last footage of Nepal. How appropriate, because after this Santiago and I said goodbye, and I also rushed on my way back to India overland to take my flight from Kolkata. Please, never ever do the Kathmandu-Kolkata journey overland. After 18 hours of bus drive and rickshaw, I found myself in Bihar, one of the poorest states of India. Here I took not one but two trains and one taxi in order to get to the airport of Kolkata and to get to my plane to Myanmar. After a total of 39 hours of travel, waiting time not included. Never again. See you next time in Myanmar.